An amazing day to all. This is Teacher Dan Rogayan and welcome to our final coaching for biological science majors. Ilang araw na lang at board exam nyo na. So I hope that you have prepared enough and that you have exerted a lot of effort in the preparation for your upcoming board come Sunday, October 2, 2020. Sa lahat ng mga nanood ng ating part 1 to part 4 LET majorship review drill, maraming salamat and thank you for all your appreciation and thank you for all your good and spirit lifting comments. No, I really appreciate that. And for today, no, this will be our final coaching for bio majorship. And I hope, no, na alam na ninyo ang mga sagot dito because you have prepared, no, for the past ilan ba? For the past 6 months or less or for the past years, no? If you have been preparing, no, since before. So let me first share my screen, no, so we can start. All right. So I hope the screen is now visible. So again, welcome to our final coaching, BioSci majorship. These questions might help you know. Remember your salient concepts and principles, no, in biological science. So hopefully this will also help you, no, as you take your board examination for specialization. So pag nakita yung mga tanong na to, hopefully, no, ay mabilis na ninyo tong masasagot. Alright? So let me remind you, no, of your goal, no, to pass and even top the board licensure examination for professional. And my fervent prayer para sa inyong lahat, especially to all of you biological science majors who are preparing, no, for your board exam, is that you will all pass the board. Now, let's manifest and let's claim it that you will become licensed professional teacher before the year ends. No, yes. So first question, no, what is the control center of the cell? A, nucleus, B, nucleolus, C, chromosome, D, chromatin. Of course, a control center of the cell, that is, of course, nucleus. Yes. So that is a basic question, no, in biological science, in cell biology. Next question. These are the three fundamental parts shared by all cells, but this is not one of them. A, organelles, B, nucleus, C, cell membrane, D, cytoplasm. The answer, what is not a fundamental part of a cell? Right? Still, of course, that is nucleus. Remember that we have two, diba, types of cell, your prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. And you know very well that in prokaryotic cell, they do not have membrane-bound organelles and nucleus, okay? And so, the genetic material can only be found in nucleoid, okay? So, sa prokaryotic cell, nucleoid, while in the eukaryotic cell, you can see the genetic material in the nucleus. But remember that it's not only the nucleus that has DNA. Okay, what are the other two organelles, no, in eukaryotic cells na may DNA? So we have chloroplast and mitochondria. Okay? At which organelle are proteins manufactured? A, nucleus, B, mitochondrion, C, ribosome, D, vacuole. Oh, what's the answer? Pag nakita proteins, of course, anong organelle ang responsible para dyan? Okay? What's the answer? Yes. So you have your, that's correct, you have your ribosome. So ribosome is actually, no, okay, ribosome is actually where, no, protein synthesis, no, happens. So this is actually the site for protein synthesis in, okay. What was not one of the most abundant and lightest elements during the earliest period of the planet Earth? A, oxygen, B, hydrogen, C, sodium, D, nitrogen. With what was not? Huh? What's the answer? Future top natures? Of course, that is sodium. So sodium is not part of the most abundant and lightest elements. Remember, we have chon, diba? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. So basically, sodium is an exception. And you know very well that the most abundant gas, no, in our atmosphere is, of course, nitrogen. And the most abundant element in our body, in human body, is oxygen. Okay, next question. Since hydrogen is reactive chemical element, with what other element will you combine in to form water? A, carbon, B, oxygen, C, nitrogen, D, sodium. This is also a very easy question, no, in bio. So of course, you know very well that water is dihydrogen monoxide, no? It has two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of what? Oxygen. Kaya siya H2O. So the answer here is letter B, right? Next question. Among the elements which has been useful to man, as evidenced by a manufacturing can, kitchen, utensils, and watches. A, boron. B, chromium. C, cobalt. D, aluminum compounds. So if you're familiar with manufacturing can, kitchen, utensils, and watches, you will answer, of course, aluminum compounds. That is the answer. So among these elements, aluminum has been very, no, or most useful to humankind. Okay? During the primal planet Earth, what was formed when hydrogen combined with oxygen? Oh, syempre, alam nyo yan. When hydrogen combined with oxygen, that is, of course, water. So water here is the answer, H2. Okay? Next question. What is the process of evaporation, condensation, precipitation, infiltration, runoff, and subsurface flow of water in our planet? A, seasonal cycle. B, rain cycle. C, water cycle. D, hail cycle. What's the answer? Okay, pag nakita agad, evaporation, condensation, of course, this pertains to water cycle. Pag walang water cycle, sa board exam, ang ipipiliin natin is hydrologic cycle. Okay? Remember also, no, pag nakita nyo condensation in the board exam, that is the phase transition from gas to liquid. From gas to liquid, we have condensation. Okay? And you know, precipitation is not always liquid water. Could also be hail, could also be snow. That's why we have what we call from gas to solid, we have gas to solid, that is deposition. Gas to liquid, condensation. Okay? So next, what is formed when carbon is combined with hydrogen? Carbon is combined with hydrogen. Okay? A, methane. B, ozone. C, alcohol. D, water. What is that? Carbon and hydrogen, of course, that is methane. Okay? Methane is the answer. So, pag nakita sa board exam, carbon combined with hydrogen, methane. Ozone, you know very well that the ozone, the formula is O3. No, this is basically the ozone layer is basically the layer that protects, no, or filters the UV radiation, no, from entering the earth, which is very crucial so that the organisms, including humankind, will be protected. And remember, no, that ozone depletion has been very has been one of the most environmental issues that we face, no, in the recent years, no, due to the chlorofluorocarbons. So for now, no, the industries are trying to manufacture, no, refrigerators or air conditioners that are CFC. Right? Of the following, identify the main solvent and protoplasm of human cells that are nutrients needed by the human body for survival. So main solvent daw ng protoplasm. And you know very well that the main solvent, no, also known as the excellent solvent, or sometimes they call it universal solvent, that is water, no, which is of course protoplasm, or in the cytoplasm of humans. Okay? Of the following, identify which is not among major foods rich in protein. A, meat. B, fish. C, butter. D, nuts. So which is not rich in protein. Okay? Although it contains protein, but it's not that rich, no, compared to the rest. So that the answer here is, of course, butter. Meat, fish, and nuts are actually good sources of proteins. Butter has protein, but basically not that rich, no, compared to the three. Okay? Of the following, which will you identify as the main source of energy that come from plants in the form of sugar and starch and function as one of the structural components of living cells? A, fats. B, proteins. C, vitamins. D, carbohydrates. So nakita ninyo naman, no, sugar and starch. Pag nakita ninyo, of course, this pertain to the macromolecule carbohydrate. Tandaan, that is carbohydrate. Okay? Of the following, identify what are the building blocks of proteins essential in the formation of new protoplasm for growth and repair of worn-out of cells. No? A, minerals. B, fiber. C, amino acids. D, carbohydrates. What's the answer, future teachers, future top natures, future LPTs? Of course, pag nakita growth and repair of tissues, then building block of proteins, these are, of course, pertaining to amino acids. So building block of protein is amino acid. Building block of carbohydrate is your simple sugar of glucose. Building block of lipid, you have fatty acid or glycerol. And building block of nucleic acid are of course, your nucleic acids. Okay? I mean, nucleotides. Okay? What should form your diet if you wish to have more starch stored in your body? A, beer and malt products. B, rice and cassava. C, fruit drinks and shakes. D, more milk and chocolate. So you're trying to have more starch, no? More sugar and starch. So basically, you will eat or you will consume rice and cassava. And remember that rice is the staple food of the Filipinos. So rice, scientifically known as Oryza sativa. While cassava is Manihot isculenta. Basically, rice and cassava are classified under carbohydrates. These are the four main classes, no, of organic compounds found in organisms. And of these, no, the simple sugars are blank. A, lipids. B, proteins. C, nucleic acid. D, carbohydrates. So when we talk about simple sugars, no, basically, of course, these are carbohydrates. Okay? These are carbohydrates. So we're talking about here the different macromolecules. Okay? Sugar is fruits known as blanc. Sugar in fruits, no, is known as blanc. A, fructose. B, maltose. C, glucose. D, sucrose. What's the answer? Of course, that is, yes, that is fructose. So basically, fructose there is the, what we call the fruit sugar. Well, maltose is actually glucose plus. So glucose plus glucose, we have maltose. Well, sucrose is fructose plus glucose is sucrose. Okay, fructose plus glucose is sucrose. Okay. What causes camote leaves sold in markets to wilt? A, decreased torgor pressure. B, increased cell destruction. C, increased diffusion pressure. Or letter D, decreased diffusion. So what's the answer? Okay, yung sagot dito. Why do camote leaves sold, no, wilt? It's because of, yes, decreased, no, torgor pressure. Because of the decrease in torgor pressure. Okay? Next. These are parts of the human body's nervous system. Except A, heart. B, spinal cord. C, brain. D, nerves. What's the answer? Of course, when we talk about nervous system, these include the nerves, the brain, and the spinal cord, except the heart. Sana ulit system ang heart? Okay, that's correct. Circulatory or cardiovascular system. Kasama ni heart si blood and blood vessels. Okay? What are the two main proteins comprising skeletal muscle? A, myosin and chromatin. B, pepsin and chromatin. C, actin and myosin. D, actin and pepsin. So the two main proteins, no, comprising our skeletal muscle is, of course, ano, AM, no, actin and myosin. So actin and myosin are the two main proteins comprising our skeletal muscle. Next question, which steroids are special chemicals produced in one part of the body that control functions of other parts of the body, such as those produced by the ovaries and control function of the uterus during the menstrual cycle? A, waxes. B, phospholipids. C, hormones. D, fatty acids. What's the answer? So, these are special chemicals known as? Yes, these are hormones. And you know very well that hormones are produced by glands. And these glands are part of what system again of the human body? That is endocrine system or the hormone system of our body. And remember that the master gland is known as the pituitary gland. Okay? What is a product of biotechnology that has existed even before the industrial age? A, chemical pesticide. B, vitamin C. C, synthetic medicine. D, living bread. What is this? No, which existed, no, before the industrial age, that is the living bread. And that what is the responsible for the leavening of the bread or rising of the bread? That is, of course, our yeast, which is an example of a fungi, which of course classified under kingdom fungi. Right? Next, in chemical digestion, fat molecules are converted into blank. A, amino acids. B, enzymes. C, simple sugars. D, fatty acids and glycerol. And you know very well, no, when you talk about lipids, when you talk about fat molecules, no, the building blocks of this, of course, are fatty acids and glycerol. So, sasagot niyo, of course, fatty acids and glycerol. Right? Next, Which is the correct way of writing with capital small letters the scientific name for the onion? Okay, Allium cepa is the scientific name. A, the genus is in capital, the first letter of the genus in capital letter. B, both have capital letters in the genus and species. C, no capital letters. D, only the species is a capital letter. So what's the answer? Of course, this is a very basic question. Your answer must be yes, Allium cepa. And this is part of the binomial nomenclature, which is, of course, introduced by Carolus Linnaeus or Carl von Linné, which is considered as the father of modern taxonomy. But tinanong sa board exam, who is the father of ancient taxonomy? Of course, that is Aristotle. And Aristotle is also considered as the father of invertebrate zoology and also the father of biology, right? Which are consumers in a rice-filled community? A, weeds and algae. B, insects and mice. C, butterflies and dragonflies. D, bacteria and fungi. Pag nakita to, what are considered as consumers in a rice-filled community, that is, of course, insects and mice. So B is the right answer for pertaining to the rice-filled community. And of course, the rice, or rice sativa, serves as the, what? Autotroph or producer. Fungi that absorb nutrients from dead matter are called blank. A, neophytes. B, epiphytes. C, omnivores. D, saprophytes. So how do you call these fungi that absorb nutrients from dead matter? We call them saprophytes. Now, epiphytes are those organisms. No, usually it has a lot of leaves, no, attached in trees, no, which actually exhibit what we call commensalism. Now, they could actually get more sunlight and more precipitation, while the tree, which is which serves the attachment, no, is not harmed. So that is considered as epiphytes. Omnivores, you know that, of course, organisms that feed on both plants and animals. Okay, next question, which is at the top of the hierarchy of biological taxonomy? You know very well, no, the biological classification, the taxonomy, no, of classification, and you know that the highest is, of course, domain. If domain is not present among the options, you will choose kingdom. Next question, in the hierarchy of biology taxonomy, if domain is at the top, which is at the bottom? A, kingdom. B, species. C, genus. D, family. Which is at the bottom, of course. Okay. Yes, the least inclusive or the species. So this, the species is the correct answer. Okay. What is composed of different populations interacting within a particular area? So in other words, how do you call the group of populations? So the group of populations, now based on our level of biological organization, is of course community, right? Community is the answer, the different group of population. And of course, you know that the study of population is known as demography. Demography is the study of population. Which of the following is a community of living organisms interacting with non-living things in an environment? A, population. B, physical environment. C, genus. D, ecosystem. So we're talking about community of living organisms. A, interacting with the non-living. So we have here biotic and abiotic components. And so we pertain to what we call ecosystem. Right? So we pertain to the ecosystem. And the field of study that focuses on the study of the interaction of living and non-living is, of course, ecology. Eco means house. Study of house or study of home. Remember that our home, the only life-sustaining planet, is the Earth. Okay? What is a modified form of sexual reproduction seen among bees in which unfertilized eggs may develop in a complete individual? A, hermaphroditism. B, parthenogenesis. C, budding. D, regeneration. What's the answer? Pag nakita to, sinamong bees, no, unfertilized eggs become a complete individual. That is, of course, parthenogenesis. And of course, bees, no, actually exhibit Arinococcus parthenogenesis. No, in the honeybee Apis mellifera, unfertilized eggs normally develop into haploid by this process. No? Arinotoki, also known as Arinococcus parthenogenesis, is a form of parthenogenesis in which unfertilized eggs develop into male individuals. Okay? Next, identify the nutrition tip most important for healthy eating habits. A, eat vegetables and fruits only. B, chew your food and eat slowly. C, avoid fast food altogether. D, balance food diet and activity. So what's the answer? The nutrient or nutrition team that is most important. Of course, these are two, balance food diet and activity. So we have to balance our food diet and, of course, our activity. Which group of plants lacks vascular tissue? A, angiosperms. B, bryophytes. C, gymnosperms. D, pteridophytes. So, pag nakita to sa board exam, those group of plants that lack vascular tissues are bryophyta or the bryophytes. Pag tinanong naman, anong unique, no? Sa mga angiosperms, ang sasagot niya naman ay vessels. Okay? Next, the main source of energy for most organisms, which man gets from starchy foods and table sugar, is blank. A, glucose. B, fructose. C, sucrose. D, maltose. Of course, the main energy source, syempre, glucose. The glucose is the main product, of course, of our photosynthesis, while the byproduct is water. Or we also called water as the waste product of photosynthesis. Okay? What is the raw material of photosynthesis that enters through the stomata? A, carbon dioxide. B, oxygen. C, nitrogen. D, water. What is that raw material that enters through stomata? Of course, meron lang tayong pwedeng pagpilian sa raw material. We have, of course, carbon dioxide and water. And you know, dahil sa stomata siya, of course, we will choose carbon dioxide. Remember that the stomata are the small openings, no, in the leaves of the plant. And usually, stomata are more, no, there are more stomata in the underside, no, of the leaf, no, to avoid, no, excessive transpiration that will cause the wilting of the plant. Okay? As a student researcher, no, in science, these are activities you should do so that hypotheses can be considered scientifically valid, but these do not include A, subjecting the hypothesis to an experiment. B, finding a basis based on observable facts. C, investigating within the realm of pure philosophy. Or letter D, making our hypothesis testable. The rest are all pertaining to the method of science, no, or scientific method, except with what? Letter C, no, investigating within the realm of pure philosophy of thinking. So there is no experimentation, there is no testing of hypothesis, so just thinking. So this is basically what the philosophers did, no, in the earliest years, no, in the development of science. That's why we call them philosophers more than scientists. Scientists are those practitioners of science that make use of what we call the scientific method. Okay? Next, what do viruses lack such that they are not considered true cells? A, ability to undergo mutation. B, cellular property of heredity. C, genetic material to perform life functions. Or letter D, metabolic life-sustaining machinery. Now, I remember we emphasized this concept, no, in our review video. So we mentioned that viruses, no, metabolism. And because we have the word metabolism, anong meron dito? Yes, the metabolic life-sustaining machinery is lacking, no, among viruses. Thus, they cannot consider true. Okay? Yes, no metabolism for virus. And when you say metabolism, it pertains to the chemical reactions in the body cells that change food into energy. We have two, right? The anabolism, building up, and of course, catabolism, breaking down. This is the original cell that makes up the human body, which, when reproduced, the new cells that are needed for man to survive and function. A, male sperm. B, organelles. C, cytoplasm. D, fertilized egg. So when you see original cell, of course, you will answer the fertilized egg, no? The union of egg and sperm cell. The union of the male and female gametes will produce the fertilized egg, which will later be developed as embryo and later on as a fetus. Okay? So identify which of the following is mismatch. A, endocytosis, phagocytosis, and pinocytosis. B, passive transfer, diffusion and osmosis. C, anabolism, cellular respiration. Or letter D, catabolism, digestion of food. What's the answer? Of course, you know very well that cellular respiration is not anabolism. It is actually catabolism. So cellular respiration is a catabolic process during which glucose is broken down to release usable energy per cell. On the other hand, photosynthesis can be considered as an anabolic process, since this requires energy, you know, the building up of energy. Okay? So the release of energy, you know, during cellular respiration, as you can see, you know, is a manifestation that it is an example of catabolism. And you know very well that the raw materials for cellular respiration are the products of photosynthesis. That is why cellular respiration is a reciprocal of photosynthesis. So we have glucose plus oxygen will give us carbon dioxide plus water. So the products of cellular respiration are carbon dioxide and water. So if the board exam will ask you on the right or correct formula of cellular respiration, we have C6H12O6, the glucose, plus 6 oxygen molecules will give us 6 carbon dioxide plus 6 water molecules. So basically, that's the correct and balanced formula for cellular respiration. Now, how about for photosynthesis? Of course, for photosynthesis, we have 6 carbon dioxide plus 6 water will give us glucose, C6H12O6, and 6 oxygen. Alright, so babalik na rin lang natin. So pag tinanong sa board exam, what are the reactants of cellular respiration? You will answer glucose and oxygen. How about the products carbon dioxide and water? Okay? Resolution is to clarity, is magnification is to blank. A, light, B, size, C, I, D, stem. So clarity, resolution, magnification is size, di ba? Remember that we have different magnification in the microscope. What is the magnification again of the low power objective? For low power objective, we have 10 times. How about for the high power objective? High power objective, we have 40 times. Okay, so basically, we also have the oil immersion objective, now usually 100 or normally typically 100 times. Okay? How will you describe the disappearance of the dinosaurs on Earth? A, mutation, B, parasitism, C, extinction, D, predation. So disappearance, no longer existing, that is extinction, pagkawala. At kapag malapit ng mawala, near to extinction. Pag nanganganib, endangered. Pag native sa lugar na yon, endemic. So for example, what animal is endemic in Mindoro? Of course, you know that very well. We mentioned that in our earlier videos. Tamaraw. Bubalus mindorensis. Pagkarabaw kasi, bubalus bubalis. So what is endemic, for example, in Bohol? Of course, you know that is tarsier. Tarsius syricta. So basically, no, this is what we call endemic. Okay? A series of membrane-bound channels free of ribosomes is called blank. A, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, B, plastid, C, mitochondrion, D, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Alright? So pag free sa ribosomes, no, dalawa lang pwedeng pagpilian kasi natin dito. We're talking about here ER or the endoplasmic reticulum, A and D. So what's the answer? Future top naturalist, of course, smooth, kesha smooth, no? Free of ribosome, free of attached organelles there. So only the rough endoplasmic reticulum have ribosomes because they closely work together, no? In the protein production. Okay, so this is how it looks like. We have here the smooth endoplasmic reticulum and, of course, the rough endoplasmic reticulum with the attached ribosomes. Okay? Next. Since hydrogen is a reactive chemical element, with what will you combine it with in order to produce ammonia? A, carbon, B, nitrogen, C, potassium, D, chlorine. So hydrogen will be combined with, of course, nitrogen to produce ammonia. And so this is the chemical, structural formula for ammonia. Okay. So what region around the North Pole has severely cold temperature with ice and snow continuously covering the area? A, tropic, B, Arctic, C, Oceanic, D, Antarctic. So pag North Pole, of course, you know that very well, this pertains to the Arctic. Okay? And Arctic, no, the North Pole sits now in the middle of the Arctic Ocean on water that is almost always covered with ice. Right? That's why our coldest biome is tundra. All this biome is tumor. Okay? The largest organ inside the human body is the blank. A, brain, B, heart, C, liver, D, lungs. Well, what is the largest organ inside the human body? A very easy question. Of course, that is the liver. But if it's externally, no, what is the largest body largest organ, no, externally, we have the skin. The lungs, no, are actually the main organs for respiration. So lungs are actually main organs for respiration. Where does the dominant vegetation of mangroves thrive? A coastal zone, B, freshwater resources, sources, C, forest, D, grasslands. So the dominant vegetation of mangroves thrives in, of course, the coastal zone. Okay, and these are very crucial. The mangrove forests are crucial, no, as habitat, no, for aquatic, no, organisms, as well as the breeding site of fishes. Okay, which phase of mitosis involves lining up the chromosomes in the middle? A, telophase, B, prophase, C, anaphase, D, metaphase. So the middle, no, middle M, metaphase. All right. So the answer here is metaphase. You can see that, okay, chromosomes line up along the metaphase plate, no, which is of course an imaginary. Okay. Next, which genetic term pertains to the physical appearance of an individual? A, genotype, B, phenotype, C, haplotype, clone, or letter D, clone. So physical, phenotype, genetic, genotype. So the answer here is letter B, phenotype. So basically, these are terms, no? In genetics, we have genotype, the combination of alleles, no? An organism inherits from its parents, no? Through the genes, of course. While phenotype is the organism's appearance or the physical appearance. Example, na mga genotype here, no? www, no? Then widow's peak, straight line hair, these are the physical appearance or the phenotype. In 1952, the Hershey-Chase experiment identified lung as the molecule responsible for inheritance. What is this molecule? A, protein, B, RNA, C, amino acids, D, DNA. The answer here is, of course, your deoxyribonucleic acid or the DNA as the molecule responsible for inheritance. Okay? So a genome, on the other hand, is a complete set of genetic information in an organism. So it provides all of the information the organism requires to function. So pag tinanong, complete set of genetic information, that is genome. Okay? The different or discrete variation of genes during gene transfer from parent to offspring is known. A, chromosomes, B, dominance, C, alleles, D, recessiveness. Okay? But different or discrete variation of gene, or in the other hand, other name for genes is, of course, allele. So, sasagot ninyo, alleles, the other name for genes. In applying crop technology, which of the following will you not use? Since these are not genetically modified organisms, A, delayed ripening tomato, B, A, enhanced golden rice, C, crossbred hybrid plants, D, drought-resistant bacterium thuringiensis corn. Of course, the rest are GMO or genetically modified organism, except with crossbred hybrid plants, which are naturally done. Okay? Linnaeus placed humans under the genus Homo because man, A, hunts and gathers food, B, has a large brain and upright posture, C, loves and has a sense of humor, D, he is humus, our Latin word for dogs. So what's the answer? Of course, that is, has a large brain and upright posture. That's why we exhibit bipedalism where we actually use to our feet, no? Okay, yung dalawang feet natin to walk, to hunt, or to even run. Okay? What will result if an offspring acquired Huntington's disease as a dominant hereditary trait? A, leads to progressive brain deterioration, B, extra fingers and toes, C, high risk of heart attack, or letter D, nearsightedness. The answer, we mentioned this in our review video. So we have, of course, leads to progressive brain deterioration. So Huntington's disease, progressive brain deterioration. Okay? Next question, among inorganic compounds, what is the universal solvent in which other substance can be dissolved? A, protein, B, fat, C, mineral solids, D, water. Of course, universal solvent or excellent solvent, no, that this is water. Okay? Water is our answer. Okay? What system of classifying organisms will you use in arranging closely related species in sequence from the most primitive to the most advanced? A, biogenetic, B, chronogeriatric, C, phylogenetic, D, polygenic. What's the answer? Of course, that is phylogenetic. No? So this is part of our genetics and evolution. A phylogenetic tree, also known as phylogeny, is a diagram that depicts the lines of evolutionary descent of different species, organisms, or genes from a common ancestor. Okay? That is phylogenetic tree or phylogeny. How did scientists prepare the biological time scale of the history of life on Earth? A, by studying ancient manuscripts. B, by creating a virtual map of life. C, by consulting noted authorities in the biological fields. Or letter D, by studying rocks and fossils. The answer? Yes, of course, by studying rocks and fossils. Okay, so they study rocks and fossils to prepare the biological time scale. How do you call again the study of rocks? Okay, the study of rocks is petrology. How about the fossils? Okay, that is part of your paleontology, right? Roots that grow above the ground are A, adventitious roots, B, primary roots, C, tap roots, D, fibrous roots. What's the answer? Of course, that is your adventitious roots, no? So these are adventitious roots, the roots that grow above the ground. So you can see here the adventitious roots, no? So basically the main plant here, the roots, and then the adventitious roots actually grow, okay, above the ground. While, pag tinanong sa board exam, how do you call, no, the roots of orchids? Now, for example, these are actually aerial roots. So these naman are aerial roots. What is the science which deals with classifying organisms? A, taxonomy, B, lexicon, C, philology, D, calligraphy. So the rest are more of language except with letter A, taxonomy. So taxonomy is the science of classification, and the father of modern taxonomy, again, is Linnaeus, while the father of ancient taxonomy is Aristotle. That's correct. What will you do if you were asked to apply the most basic process in the science of taxonomy? A, map down organisms, B, differentiate organisms, C, understand organisms, letter D, identify organisms. Of course, you have to identify organisms. So this is part of our biosystematics, no, taxonomy or biosystematics. Okay, what cell process moves substances against a concentration gradient? A, osmosis, B, diffusion, C, infusion, D, active transport. So pag nakita movement of cellular transport which moves substances against a concentration gradient, we pertain to what we call active transport. Against concentration gradient, active transport. Active transport is a transfer of substance across the solid membrane against its concentration gradient. Because the movement of substances is against the concentration gradients, it requires energy or the ATP. Remember, this is active transport. An example naman of passive transport, you have your diffusion, or simple facilitated diffusion, and even your osmosis is the diffusion in water. Okay? Which will you identify as the majority of the 8.7 million species of living organisms reported by the UN Environment Program's World Conservation Monitoring Center in 2011? A, microorganisms, B, marine life, C, bacteria and viruses, D, land species. So what here is considered as the majority, no, of living organisms, okay, which has the biggest number, of course, these are land species. So according to the UN Environment Program's World Conservation Monitoring Center in 2011, approximately 6.5 million species, no, are found on land and 2.2 million in the ocean. So basically, this comprises the 8.7 million species document. But of course, you know very well that there are still undocumented species both in land and in water. That's why you might encounter discovery of new species in both land and water. Filipino scientists and researchers are really doing their best to really discover the rich some more organisms in the rich biodiversity of the. So the Philippines is also considered as a biodiversity hotspot because although we are rich in biodiversity, we are also very vulnerable to biodiversity destruction due to different anthropogenic activities as well as different environmental problems. According to the latest study, a crocodile is now being compared as similar to blank rather than lizard, iguana, and the like. A, birds, B, leopards, C, dolphins, D, whales. So, anong crocodile now is compared to or similar to? Of course, birds. No, nadaanan natin to, no, in one of our review videos as well. So you can see here the alligators, gharial, crocodiles, no, these are reptiles, no, which is of course okay, very connected to what we call the birds. Like ostrich, chicken, penguin, pigeon. So of the following ecosystem, which can be identified as the richest in terms of number of species they sustain? A, mangrove forest and fish pan, B, grassland and wetland, C, pine forest and national park, or letter D, dipterocarp and coral reef. The answer, the richest in terms of number of species they sustain, these are dipterocarps and coral reefs. So remember, the coral reefs are believed by many to have the highest biodiversity of any ecosystem on the planet, even more than a tropical rainforest. So occupying less than 1% of the ocean floor, coral reefs are home to more than 25% of all marine life. And you know very well that corals are animals classified under phylum Cnidaria. Kasama niyan ang mga sea animals. Okay? Sodium chloride or table salt is an example of which of the following? A, chemical compound, B, element, C, chemical formula, D, radioactive isotope. So NaCl, table salt, is of course chemical compound. So it has sodium and it has chlorine. What is the process of water evaporating from the leaves of plants? No, we've been, you know, emphasizing this concept. A, respiration, B, photosynthesis, C, transpiration, D, evaporation. So the answer is, of course, transpiration. Transpiration is the evaporation in plants. And this is also responsible, no, by moving, no, water molecules among tall trees. So transpiration among tall trees. While capillary action usually moves water from the roots to above the ground. Huh? So that is transpiration versus capillary action. Indicate the cause of cholera, which killed millions of people during an epidemic in Europe. A, dirty water, B, protists, C, virus, D, bacterium. So cholera is of course caused by Vibrio cholerae bacterium. So it's a bacterium or a bacteria which is responsible for cholera. But tinanong, what is responsible for the COVID-19 disease is of course a virus known as the coronavirus. Kaya nga, tinawag, no, the first name of the COVID-19 is nCoV, no, novel coronavirus. When you say novel, bago, no, still and studied or not fully studied. Okay? Cholera is an acute diarrheal illness caused by an infection of the intestine with Vibrio cholerae bacteria. And pag tinanong sa board exam, what is the shape of this bacteria? You will answer comma shape. Vibrio cholerae, comma shape. Okay? Scurvy is a disease caused by what vitamin deficiency? A, ascorbic acid, B, cyanocobalamin, C, folic acid, D, thiamine. Of course, scurvy, ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid. So this is the deficiency if you lack, okay, ascorbic acid or vitamin C, you will have scurvy. Pag tinanong naman, what is the deficiency naman? What is lacking or what is vitamin deficiency for? Rickets. So that is vitamin D. Rickets, vitamin D. Pag kwashiorkor, usually this lacks protein, while marasmus lacks nutrient, no? Or nutrient deficient. Okay? Next, what kind of organism is the schistoma, which causes schistosomiasis, a tropical disease traced to contaminated water? A, virus, B, flatworm, C, fungus, D, protist. So schistoma is a genus, no, under flatworm. Okay, so that is flatworm. Okay, schistosomiasis or bilharziasis is caused by some species of blood trematodes or flukes, no, trematoda or flukes, no, in the genus schistosoma, which is of course under the phylum Platyhelminthes. Because remember that flukes, no, like planaria, are actually flat. Okay? Which protist causes malaria? A, Plasmodium, B, Staphylococcus, C, Euglena, D, Neelhazia. What's the answer? Pag malaria, of course, that is Plasmodium. Malaria, Plasmodium. So you have your Anopheles mosquito. Well, for dengue, that is Aedes aegypti, and dengue is caused by a virus naman. Okay? So basically, pag tinanong ang mosquito under what phylum, this is phylum Arthropoda. And Arthropoda is the largest phylum in the animal kingdom, which of course includes the insects. What is the hierarchical system of ranking organism introduced by Linnaeus, no? From the broadest to the most specific. A, two, king A, two kingdoms, classes, orders, genera, species. B, species, genera, orders, classes, two kingdoms. C, species, genera, two kingdoms. Or letter D, two kingdoms, genera, or species. So from broadest to most specific, of course, ang pinaka-broad natin is the kingdom. So we have two kingdoms. Okay, yun yung two kingdom classification before now. But now we have our six kingdom classification to include kingdom Eubacteria and kingdom Archaebacteria. Okay? Apart from the Protista, fungi, plantae, and Animalia. Okay? So then orders, no? Pag tinanong what is the order of humans, order Primata or primates. Genera is of course the plural form for genus. Genus, no? And the genus of humans are Homo. Is Homo, no? And species C. Yeah, that's why Homo sapiens sapiens of our modern humans. What will you choose as the highest category in the hierarchy of classification of living organisms? A, domain, B, kingdom, C, phylum, D, family. Of course, the highest category, yes, that is domain, followed by kingdom, followed by phylum. Don, King, Philip came to order fresh green spinach, you know, the mnemonics that we have been using. Okay? Which of the following is a vertebrate? A, sea anemone, B, planaria, sea sponge, D, wolf. Siyempre, alam na alam mo, vertebrate, makita mo lang ang wolf, you know very well that it is vertebrate since it belongs to phylum Chordata. Letter A, sea anemone belongs to phylum Cnidaria, planarian belongs to phylum Platyhelminthes, while sponge belongs to phylum Perniferia. Na ano sa F, no? Planaria, phylum, no? Platyhelminth, flatworms, yes. Okay? So how will you classify photosynthetic microorganisms under the two kingdom scheme of biological classification? May mga nagtanong sa akin ito. Okay, remember pag two kingdom lang yung nasa stem natin, two kingdom lang, dalawa lang yun, plantae or animalia. So doon lang tayo pipili. Kasi nga, in-specify eh, di ba, under the two kingdom. So anong isasagot? Siyempre, hindi na natin isasagot ang protista. Okay? So isasagot natin between animalia and plantae under kingdom plantae. Pero pag walang sinabing two kingdom classification, you will answer protista. Kapag naman six kingdom classification, normally, syempre, ang isasagot na niya dyan ay protista. Because this include, of course, your algae and cyanobacteria. Okay? Among the main trophic levels which denote the transfer of energy and matter in a biological community, the blank are plants and some organisms which make their own. Pag nakita niya agad, plants and some organisms creating or manufacture their own food, of course, you are referring to producer. Okay? You are referring to producer. Okay? Next, why are animal scavengers like vultures and crows known as the cleanup patrol of an ecosystem? A, they collect debris. B, they are omnivores. C, they thrive in dump sites. Or letter D, they feed on dead animals. Why do we consider them tawag dito, clean up patrol. What's the answer? Of course, you're referring to, or your answer must be letter, yes, letter D, no? They feed on dead animals. So they clean up these dead animals and feed on it. These are what we call the scavengers. Okay? Identify which of the following is not true about tapeworms. A, they are animals. B, they are saprozoic. C, they have special saprotrophic nutrition. Or letter D, they are autotrophic. You know very well that tapeworms are animals, no? Which, of course, classified under phylum Platyhelminthes. And so they are autotrophic is not, no? Correct description about tapeworms. Because tapeworms are actually heterotrophic, which feeds on the host, no? Ina-attach nila. Usually, tapeworms, human can actually be a host, no, for these parasites. And human is classified as an animal. Okay? Under phylum, Ornata. How will you classify large single eukaryotic cells such as green and red algae under the Six Kingdom system? Ito yung sinasabi ko. A. Archaea, B. Animalia, C. Protista, D. Plantae. Of course, you will answer Protista. So, kingdom protist. Okay? And you know that protists involve also your protozoa. No? So you have your protozoa. Okay? Which of the following is protected by an exoskeleton? A. Periphera, B. Echinodermata, C. Crustacea, D. Chordae. What the answer? Protected by an exoskeleton, syempre you have your crustacean under phylum Arthropoda. No? Under phylum Arthropoda. So that is crustacean. Example ng mga crustaceans, of course, you have your crabs, diba? Yes. The Latin word virus was introduced by Dutch biologist Martinus Beijerinck to name tiny disease-causing agents, and the word means blank. A, life, B, strength, C, poison, D, male. So, virus, no, literally means, yes, this pertains to poison. So, again, pag nakita again, a little support exam, virus is poison. Nadaanan din natin to during our review video. Which is mismatched by way of scientists and contributions to science? A. Gregor Mendel, father of genetics. B. Carolus Linnaeus, father of modern taxonomy. C. Sir Alexander Fleming, father of medical surgery. D. Louis Pasteur, founder of microbiology. Of course, syempre lahat ay tama except si Alexander Fleming. Remember that Alexander Fleming is responsible for the discovery of the penicillin or the penicillium notatum. So usually sa board exam nilalagay din siya father of penicillin. So A, of course, Gregor Mendel, father of genetics, Carolus Linnaeus, father of modern taxonomy, Louis Pasteur is founder of microbiology. The same with Robert Koch, no, he's also considered founder of microbiology. Sometimes Louis Pasteur is also being considered as father of microbiology, no? But basically ang dami kasi din nila, no, which contributed a lot in the field of microbiology. Okay? Who did Albert Einstein call father of modern science for use of scientific method in such experiments as falling bodies, telescope that viewed the moons of Jupiter, and thermometer based on density of liquids? A. Francis Bacon, B. Erasmus, C. Galileo Galilei, D. Copernicus. So the father of modern science, no, is, of course, Galileo Galilei. Galileo Galilei is considered as a father of modern science. Who first used the word genetics? A. Emrys Aesthetics, B. Hugo de Vries, C. Gregor Mendel, D. Charles Darwin. Okay, the first one who used the word genetics is actually, that's correct, Emrys Aesthetics. So Emrys Aesthetics actually used the word genetics. Gregor Mendel, the father of genetics, okay, which coined the term heritable factor and eventually become gene. Okay? Charles Darwin is the father of evolution. Okay. So aesthetics formulated a number of rules of heredity and was the first to refer to this as genetic laws of nature. Die genetischen Gesetze der Natur. So German, yeah. Okay? So next. Who accidentally discovered penicillin, which ushered the era of antibiotics? A. Alexander Fleming, B. Louis Pasteur, C. Robert Koch, D. Joseph Lester. What's the answer? Okay, that's correct. Alam na alam natin yan. Alexander Fleming, no? Which discovered it by serendipity or discovery by accident. Okay? In measure of central location, the blank is used for the arithmetic average. A, mode, B, mean, C, median, D, medium. Of course, arithmetic average is, of course, your mean. So mean here is the answer. Mode is, of course, the most frequent score. The median is the middle score. Usually, you just have to arrange, no, the number from lowest to highest. And if it's odd number, you just get the middle score. So that's already your median. But if it's even number, you have to get the two middle numbers divided by two. And so that will be your mean. Well, the range, no, range naman is the difference between the highest and the lowest score. So this is part of your biostatistics. So in measure of central location, the blank is used for the arithmetic average. Ayan, na-wait lang to. So that is, of course, your A. Okay? So which will you use, no, as the most stable measure of central tendency when associated with interval or ratio data with distribution being normal. A median, B mode, C mean, D both mean and mode. Basically, kapag being normal naman, normal distribution, so the most stable measure pa rin will be your mean. Okay? Your mean. But of course, mean will not be a reliable, okay, stable measure kapag may mga outliers. Okay? So, ayan. So, hopefully, no, maraming lumabas dito sa ating mga sample questions, no, for our final coaching at sa lahat ng ating review videos from part 1 to 4. No? So, marami sa inyo yung nag-marathon ng videos natin ng Biological Science Majorship from part 1 to 4 that you can see from this channel, Teacher Dan Rugayan. And thank you so much again, no, for being with me, no, in this review journey. And I am praying, no, I am looking forward that most, and all of you, actually not most, but all of you will be able to pass and top the board exam. No? So, bumalik kayo, no, sa channel natin just in case na meron ng announcement, no, of the results of your board examination. And I would want and I would be very excited to know and see all of your names, no, in the list or in the roster of the new and newly licensed, no, professional teachers, no, come December ba, December, no, 2022. So maraming salamat, no, to all of you once again. I really appreciate all your support and all your appreciation, all your message of thanks and message of gratitude. So I hope na nakatulong, no, yung ating naging review series, no, for biological science sa inyong preparation for the board exam. And by next year, magkakaroon na kasi tayo ng bagong table of specification and we will be focusing na on general science or science in general. So basically, we'll have majorship in science in general comprising pa rin naman of biopart. So mga magtitake pa rin naman sa March 2023, they can still use, no, our review videos for biological science part 1 to 4 and itong ating final coaching ngayon. And hopefully I can still upload, no, in the coming weeks, no, para naman matulungan natin yung mga susunod na magtitake ng board licensure examination for professional team. So sa general team, no, kailangan i-clear na natin yung mind natin when we go on the day of your exam. Wala na magbabasa on the day of your exam, wala na magre-review. Apayapain na ninyo ang inyong sarili, ang inyong mind, no, clear your mind para mabilis ninyong masasagot yung mga items natin. Not only, of course, in your biological science majorship, but also in your professional education and even in your general education. Pwede nyo pa rin balikan yung ating Gen Ed Biological Science and Gen Ed Physical Science videos. These two videos are focusing on, mainly on Gen Ed Biological Science, pero pwede rin may mga tanong doon na ilagay nila sa majorship nyo. Hopefully na napanood na rin ninyo. And of course, for Gen Ed Physical Science, remember, may mga questions pa rin sa physical science na nailalagay din sa inyong majorship. Kaya mapapansin nyo, some of the questions are kind of like may mga pagka-physical science. But of course, these two videos on Gen Ed Physical and Biological Science can also help you a lot in your general education. This can also be very helpful to those non-bio majors. So again, maraming salamat, no. Actually, ano, sa dami ng trabaho, hindi ko na sana gagawin yung final coaching, pero dahil marami po ang nagko-comment, no, ng final coaching, ito na po yan. And hopefully po ay makatulong po tong ating video nito, no, in your in passing, no, in topping the course. So i-claim na natin, no, future LPTs. Maraming salamat once again. This is your Agamazing Guru, Teacher Dan Rugayan. God bless. And see you again, no? And hopefully, if I can see you in flesh, you would, you know, we could at least share some pleasantries about your journey, no, in the licensure examination for perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much.